this is something that is really...
Chicago Blackhawks versus Vancouver Canucks. The two best teams in the league are versing right now.
A period where you're shorthanded three times.
And again, we talk about it so often, Pat, that... I mean, just in general. I mean, the general principles. Not everybody kills penalties. You don't see Patrick Kane for a long duration. And if you're going to take a penalty, it's got to be a good one. Look, sometimes it happens. And I love the point that Stevie Conroy, Matt, made with Danny, is that, hey, you know what? Those are three penalties that shouldn't have happened.
Penalty now over as Oduya put a pass behind Schott. It's held into Hendrick, a long shot, and a save. Puck rebound jumps right through the legs of Kessler, and the Hawks get out. Schott, extra move of the line. That is offside. And the whistle sounds. By the way, this line for Vancouver that started up, again, they had about 8 minutes of power play time. But between the Twins and Ryan Kessler, they were all on the ice for about 9 minutes out of the first 20. That's virtually unheard of for a forward.
Yeah, they do play a lot. And as we said at the top of the show, Pat, they average in all 22-plus minutes a night, which is extremely high. With Jonathan Toews in that 20-minute range, it may not seem like a lot, but that's, you know, four shifts, five shifts in a game. Well, if you are going to play a lot, we talked about earlier, get on the body on those guys. But in order to do that, you got to play it even straight. Can't be chasing around.
Andrews jammed it along the boards. Cassian has a little space. Bounced it out. Here comes Stanton with a shot right into the crest of Corey Crawford. Ryan Stanton. Blackhawks fans may not be that familiar with him, but he was with the Blackhawks for a number of years in their organization. The last two seasons, for a kid that was undrafted, this is pretty good. He was the top defenseman in Rockford the last 2 years. The year before that, he was the most improved player for the Rockford IceHawks. And the Hawks were really worried about trying to send him down this year because he would have had he had to go through waivers in order to be sent down. But just because of a number situation with the parent team, they did put him on waivers, and the Canucks scooped him up. Yeah, and he's been a regular here ever since.
He's got a real good opportunity.
All right, Toews, 3-on-2. Toews moves in, dropped it to the middle. Here's Oduya. Missed the net. Tried to go high glove. Shot it up too high. And it's cleared back to center. Well, that's an offside play. Well, the whistle sounds.
Oh, glorious opportunity, Pat, for the captain coming down those right-wing boards. And I thought Jonathan Toews was going to shoot that puck, Pat. He's a left-handed shot coming down the right-wing boards. It's a 2-on-1 that turned into a 3-on-2, as you mentioned. He's right there inside the dots and throws a backhand back to Johnny Oduya, who missed the net. But Jonathan Toews looking up at the Jumbotron, Pat, looking at that last replay and going to school there. Should have shot that puck.
Hughes. Miss Kessler, it's held in. Here's a blast. Peary missed the net with a rocket. And Kessler then checked by Peary. And finally he winds up at center. Here comes Ryan Kessler. Put it in. Daniel to Hendrick. He looks back to Daniel, trying to center Kessler a tip. And it's top cross. Rebound. He made a second save as Hughes joins the play. Now Peary for Versteen, then Kane. Patrick Kane trying to get to the middle. Could not. His backhander's wide. And Kane kicks it loose to Oduya. Kane retrieves it. Versteen sandwiched in the corner. Hawks don't dig it out. Jalmerson. And it bounced off a couple of skates. And Ellie Daniel Sedin got it out of there. Brookbank, but played it up the boards, and Sestito couldn't get it out. Held into Brookbank, tried a shot that stopped by Luongo. Good screen out in front by Andrew Shaw. Brookbank just got it to the net. That turned into a tough save because of some good work from Shaw.
It was like a pinball machine, Pat, after it left the stick of Sheldon Brookbank. Andrew Shaw in front, along with Kevin Bieksa, standing in front of the net. and go back to a save by Corey Crawford. Boy, a quick bang-bang play, the redirection from Kessler in front of the net, and then the opportunity for Hamhuis, who jumped into the play. Two really good stops there from Corey Crawford. And that one by Roberto Luongo was a real difficult stop. I mean, the puck changed direction about 4 feet in front of him off the...